Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome to another art journal layout. I'm starting out with my go-to technique. So first of all, I'm going to cut out a piece of tissue paper, which I'm going to stick on both my pages of my layout, and I'm using a matte medium by DecoArt. I'm applying a matte medium on my pages using a brush, and once I have applied enough, I'm going to stick the tissue paper on top. I'm using my bone folder to make sure that I don't have any creases, although in other layouts I want to have creases since I can create a texture by that. Once your tissue paper is on your layout, you can then leave it to dry, but if you are like me and I don't like to wait, I just want to move on with my techniques, I prefer using my heat gun to dry everything. And once that's dry, I'll be using my scissors to cut around the excess tissue paper. And now for the fun part. I have my collection of DecoArt Media Fluid Acrylics, and I'm trying to decide which colors I'm going to use for my background. I decided to go with Diary Light Yellow and Transparent Yellow Iron Oxide. You can find all the colors that I'm using just below the video in the details area with links to each color. Now, as you can see, I'm applying the color with a baby wipe, and you can see how fluid it is and how easy it is to apply. The blending is perfect, and what I love about these fluid acrylics is that they dry permanent. So I'm pretty much safe to do whatever I want on top once they dry. To add a darker color on my page, I'm introducing Burnt Sienna, which I'm going to apply with a baby wipe, but also I'm going to blend in with my fingers. Fluid acrylics don't dry instantly, so you have a few seconds to move the paint around or blend it with your fingers, your brush, or whatever you want to use. Now that I'm happy with my background, I could have left it aside to dry, or since I'm always in a hurry, I'm using my heat gun to make sure everything is nice and dry. And now I can go over it with a stencil. This is a stencil by Tim Holtz, and it's called Clockwork, and I'm also using another fluid acrylic paint, which is Burnt Umber. To apply my paint, I'm using a blending tool by Tim Holtz, and I'm just dabbing over the stencil. And you can see the result, it's pretty easy to do. And since I'm making today an art journal about the new year, I thought that this stencil with the clocks is pretty appropriate, since it's all about the new year, numbers and time. If you take a closer look on what I'm doing, you'll see that I'm not picking up too much paint with my blending tool. A little goes a long way in this case, and you don't really want your blending tool to be very wet, because then the paint will go under your stencil. Just because I'm applying so little paint over the stencil, it dries instantly, and I'll showcase how permanent it is with my baby wipe. You see that I rub over the paint and it doesn't move, blend or smudge in any way. To add more texture on my background, I'm using this modeling paste, which is nice and thick, and it's also by DecoArt, and I'm going over this stencil with the stars. The stencil is by Tim Holtz. This modeling paste, although it looks very white, it actually dyes semi-transparent, and you'll see what I mean as I go on with the layout. And also, one of the great attributes of this modeling paste is that it takes paint beautifully, and it doesn't resist anything, any color on top. And time to do some more stenciling. I'll be using the same technique, just like I did before, with my acrylic paint over the stencil with the blending tool. The color that I'm using is gold, and it's one of the metallics from the DecoArt Fluid Acrylics line, and you can see the shimmer. It's so pretty. And you can see it's also very easy to clean the stencils. This is a layout about the new year, so it's time to stamp the numbers. I'm using these big numbers, which is from a Tim Holtz stamp set that's called Numeric. And I'm just placing them there, deciding where everything is going to go. And now I'll go ahead and stamp them using Archival Ink. I'm using the jet black color. And since I have some texture and a lot of things going on my page already, it doesn't stamp quite smoothly, but I really don't mind since I can go ahead later and fill in the gaps with my black marker. And now for some die cutting. I had this idea to create some pockets where I can place some wishes for the new year. So I'm using this die, which is an exclusive die by Simon Says Stamp. And as always, you can find the link down below in the details area. So this is called Tiny Square Envelope, I believe. And I'm using this pattern paper from Prima. So I'm going to be using my Cuttleback die cutting machine, and I'm going to cut out 3 of those envelopes. At this point, I have pretty much decided the color scheme for my layout, so I'm sticking with yellows, gold, and dark red. Now that my die cuts are ready, I'm using my scissors and I'm going to cut out one of the flaps from each envelope that I don't really want. So I'll leave that aside, and with my bone folder I'm going to fold everything in. The die that I have used already made some scoring lines, so it's pretty easy for me to just fold everything in. And finally I'll be using some tape adhesive to assemble the envelopes. My envelopes are all ready now, and so I'll be using my blending tool together with burnt umber from the fluid acrylics, and I'm going all over the edges. This will add some paint on my envelopes, and it will help them blend in better with the rest of my layout. To stick those tiny little envelopes on my layout, I'll be using matte medium at the back, and I'm applying the medium with my paintbrush. And now to bring everything together, I'm going to use my modeling paste with this stencil with the stars that I've used earlier, and I'm going to add a few stars here and there on the envelopes. And at this point you can see how the rest of the stars aren't so white. As they dry, they become semi-transparent, but the texture is still there. I am going to be doing the same technique with my numbers to make them more part of the page and bring everything together, just like I did with the envelopes. And again, although those stars look very opaque and bold, they won't be like that once they dry. This is one of my favorite Tim Holtz booklets. It has tickets with nice words, which I'm going to be using to insert in my pockets. To help those tickets blend in with the color scheme and the rest of the page, I'll be using my blending tool to apply some color on the edges. And again, I'm using two colors that I have used previously on my page, so that's burnt amber together with gold metallic. What's great about these DecoArt Media Fluid Acrylics is that they are not heavy body acrylics, they are fluid, so they are quite runny, and that allows you to do this technique easily. Once I'm done by applying burnt amber all over the tickets, I'll go ahead and do the same technique with my gold, and I'm not sure if you can see the shimmer at the moment, but I'll make sure to catch the light later on, so you can see how pretty they look. Oh, and while I'm doing that, just to let you know about my craft mat. I get a lot of questions about this. This is by Ranger, and you can find a link just below the video in the details area. It's great to work on it, since you can just wipe everything off with a baby wipe or just a towel. So now it's time to put the tickets inside the pockets. And another idea would be to write down your resolutions and insert them in these pockets, or write them at the back, or just write wishes or any words you want to add. And now it's time to work on the left page of my layout. I have these dies from Simon Says Stamp. These are exclusive dies, and I have die cut two balloons. So I'm going again with the same distress technique. I'm going all around the edges of the balloons by using burnt amber. Although it looks quite heavy at the moment, it won't look like that once I'm finished. So first of all, I'm going quite heavily at the edges, and then I'll use a baby wipe and go all over the balloon with it. This will blend in the color nicely, and it will add a great texture. As you might have noticed, I've used the same pattern paper to cut out the balloons as the one that I've used for the envelopes. Once I'm happy with the outcome, I'll be using gel medium to stick the balloons on my page. I have used my heat gun over the balloons to speed up the drying process, and now I'm using my scissors to cut out the excess. One of the things that I love to do on my layouts, and I think that really attracts the eye and make them more interesting, is to stick things that go outside the page. I did that, if you noticed, with my numbers. With my white gel pen, I'm going all over the numbers and I'm adding some highlights here and there. And then I'll be using my black marker and I'll go all over the edges of the balloons to add some interest and define the edges. Notice that I do sketchy lines. I don't go all over the edges with a continuous line. And now, to add some highlights on the balloons, instead of using any other medium, I decided to go with the stencil and add some white stars on one side of each balloon. Now, at this point, I decided that I have added too much of stars there, but you can see how easy it is to remove the modeling paste when you have matte medium at the bottom. And again, I'm using the DecoArt modeling paste, and that means that it won't stay as white, and it will blend in nicely with the background and be more semi-transparent. So I'll go ahead and add a couple of stars in the other balloon as a highlight. And if you look on the right of the screen at the moment, you'll see that I have my little helper with me. He's always on my craft table, looking at me when I work. To add more texture and interest on my page, I'll be using these ribbons, and I'll just apply some of them here and there. These are all about clocks and numbers, so I think they are pretty appropriate. One of the funniest things that I did on this layout was that I was keep messing with the stars on the small balloon. So these three stars, I had to add them again and again. You can see that I messed up once now, and you see me messing them up again and again later on. Just because I wasn't too patient for them to dry, and I just kept adding things all over them, without thinking that they were still wet. Actually, at this point, you can see that the three stars aren't there, since I have messed them up somehow. And anyway, it's time for me to stamp my sentiment. I'm going with the word happy, and I'm stamping with Archival Ink, and I'm using Worn Text by Tim Holtz. That's one of my favorite alphabet stamps. And again, just like I did with my numbers, I'll go over the letters with my marker to make it bold and to help the letters stand out. And now that I've finished with that, I'll go ahead and add the stars again on the balloon. So I'll take the stars stencil together with my spatula and the modeling paste, and add them again. I think that's the third time I'm doing it at the moment, and believe me, I kept doing it again and again. So now I want to add some highlights with my gel pen over the letters, but just because the ink isn't dry yet, my gel pen doesn't write on top. So I'm using my heat gun to make sure that it's nice and dry, and you'll see that my gel pen writes perfectly now on top. So I'm going over the letters, adding just a thin line only on the left side of each letter. And at this point, I decided to grab my gold metallic paint and just go over the balloons to add some shimmer. So you see what I mean about those stars? I forgot they were wet, and now I have to wipe them out again. So I'll continue with adding shimmer with my gold paint, and then I'll go ahead and add the stars again later on. I'm also going to add some gold paint with my finger over the numbers, just a bit here and there to add some shimmer. And now I'm going to create two bows for the balloons. I'm using white thread together with gold thread, and I'm just creating two tiny bows which I'm going to stick over the balloons with matte medium. And that was the art journal for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel, as well as leave me a comment. All the supplies are listed just below the video in the details area or on my blog. Thank you all for watching.